We are gonna start today with a little bit of hardwood farming. So today we're gonna start with a little hardwood farming. And I've had a few questions in the last couple weeks about manure and alfalfa, and we could take that to different levels with other crops. But we're gonna start today talking about a few things that people have asked me over the last week or two. So we're at that point where we got some large yards, maybe some dairies that have got some manure, they got their silage chopped. I've been getting the question, can we put some manure out this fall and be able to plant alfalfa next spring? So I want some of you guys to chime in on this. So you got the old applicator out there. This was a great reason for me to break that out of the box and get it out so we could play with it today. And the stagger's on there for you, John Deal. Yeah. But folks, we have lots and lots of dairymen that will take their dairy manure, put it out there this fall, get it applied, and actually go back and plant alfalfa over the top of that next year. And anybody listening to this, I want your input, advice, experiences as well as people ask about fertility and planting some alfalfa. But to me, it works really good. I know we've had guys do probably up to 15,000 gallons of manure. The one thing that I would caution is when we get that applied in those bands, that they also come back and do some pretty good tillage so they get that blended in, mixed in well. Otherwise, if you don't do very much to get that mixed in well, you can have strips or streaks in your alfalfa where you can see right where those bands went. So get that applied and blended in pretty well. Again, I threw the old manure spreader out here. Couple other applicators that might have something to do with some fertility going out as well. And one thing for alfalfa that I want to remind everybody is get lime on. If you have a pH that's under 6.5, I mean, alfalfa really likes to have a pH somewhere 6.8 to 7.2. So if your pH is lower than that, we really need to get that fixed. So get that lime applied. If you're higher than 7.2, it's really not that big of a deal from a pH standpoint, but really what it affects the most is how your nutrients are available. So you just have to manage nutrients a little bit differently when you get up into the upper sevens, into the eights, mid eights. So the big one is a low pH. We need to get that corrected because it affects more on nodulation and root development of an alfalfa plant. So a little bit of hardwood farming this morning from Jeff Jackson, the Forage Fan Addict. Hope you're all having a great Wednesday. Looks like a beautiful one out there. Go get them.